the Lord is to set me free.
I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
I go until I find what the end may be.
I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
One day I was walking along.
I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
I know I heard a voice, but I saw no one.
I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
The voice I heard sounded oh so sweet.
I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
I came down from my head to the soles of my
feet. I wanna cross over to see my Lord.
Get away.
Jordan.
Get away.
Jordan.
Get back.
Get back, Jordan. I want to cross over to see my Lord.
Get away.
Get away, Jordan.
Get away.
Get away, children, Jordan.
Oh, get back.
Get back, way back, Jordan. I want to cross over to see my Lord.
Little one of these mornings and it won't be long.
I want to cross over to see my Lord.
You're going to look for me, child, but I'll be gone.
I want to cross over to see my Lord.
Just a few more rises and settings of the sun.
I want to cross over to see my Lord.
My battles be fought and my victories won.
I want to cross over to see my Lord.
All the friends I used to love so dear.
I want to cross over to see my Lord.
Well, they've gone on to glory and all their
feet.
I want to
cross over to see my Lord.
When my feet get cold, eyes are shut. Body will chill by the hand of death. My tongue is glued to the roof of my mouth. Hands lay folded across my breast. I won't have to worry about the way I feel. Now I'm out of the tomb, he'd be right there. He'll lift me up on the wings of love. Deliver my soul into heaven above. Tell the Jordan kid to fight. I'm going around the mirror on the other side. Get away!
Get away, Jordan.
Oh, get away!
Get away, chilly Jordan.
Get away!
Get back, way back, Jordan.
Get Away Jordan, a former number one song from Ernie Haas and Signature Sound, and this is the Gospel Time program. I'm the host, Dave Rigg. During this half hour, it's going to be my privilege to bring to you the Gospel of Jesus Christ in song. Here's a song from the Tally Trio. It's called A Red Letter Day. You're listening to Gospel Time.
I'm having a red letter.
In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 19, verse 10, we find the words of the Lord Jesus. The Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost. Would you pause just a moment with me for a word of prayer? Our Lord Jesus, while we know that you hate sin and the mess that it creates in our lives, we are so thankful that when you came to earth, you did not come to be our judge, but our Savior. Oh Lord Jesus, we promise you today to live in such a way that we might be more aware of your love for the lost people, because, well, we know what it means to be found. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's in your precious and holy name that we pray, and amen.
Back to Genesis with Dr. John Morris, creation researcher and scientist with ICR. Dr. Morris, whatever happened to the oscillating universe theory?
Chris, this was an earlier idea that claimed that the universe's present expansion from the Big Bang is just one of many cycles of shrinking and expansion. That idea is out of favor now, but it's seeing a revival. It's called the Big Crunch. It's only moderately different from the oscillating universe with just one Big Bang, and then after a trillion years or so, a big crunch of all the matter into a single dense particle. This seems to solve some of the problems with the Big Bang, but I wonder. I suspect it just puts God and his creation farther away and still allows them to believe in a naturalistic universe while recognizing the evidence for a start. Chris, it's much more satisfying to simply go back to Genesis.
Thanks, Dr. Morris. For more on Genesis, visit us on the web at www.icr.org. That's www.icr.org.
Our next song is from Mike and Kelly Bowling, and this is called We Have a Savior.
Valleys bounded by mountains with peaks that seem too high to climb, and I recall learning how great mountain climbers conquer one step at a time. I've watched blue rivers with strong currents raging and wondered if they could be crossed. But my rivers and mountains became soft, gentle fountains because of an old rugged cross.
We have a Savior, such a wonderful Savior. Mercy's atonement, stifled sin's judgment, grace made intercession, I'm free. Cause the pain and the heartache, the suffering I can't take, purchased redemption for me. And the true Lamb of Calvary is the hope of salvation. He died on the old rugged tree. Down sidewalks of bright neon cities where the skyscrapers reach for the sky. I've seen the rich and the famous in glamour and glitter as they search for some joy in the night. While a few blocks from Main Street in an old cardboard ghetto, another unknown life is lost. But whether penthouse or skid row, there's one thing I still know. There's hope in the old rugged cross. We have a Savior, such a wonderful Savior. Mercy's atonement, stifled sin's judgment, grace made intercession, I'm free. Cause the pain and the heartache, the suffering I can't take, purchased redemption for me. And the true Lamb of Calvary is the hope of salvation. He died on the old rugged tree. Oh yeah. What a wonderful Savior. And the true Lamb of Calvary is the hope of salvation. He died on the old rugged tree.
It is right that I should feel as I do about all of you, for you have a very special place in my heart. We have shared together the blessings of God both when I was in prison and when I was out, defending the truth and telling others the good news. God knows how much I love you and long for you with the tender compassion of Christ Jesus. I pray that your love for each other will overflow more and more, and that you will keep on growing in your knowledge and understanding. For I want you to understand what really matters, so that you may live pure and blameless lives until Christ returns. May you always be filled with the fruit of your salvation, those good things that are produced in your life by Jesus Christ. For this will bring much glory and praise to God. Philippians chapter 1, verses 7 through 11, from the Holy Bible, New Living Translation, for those who thirst.
This is Gospel Time, a radio ministry. We depend upon your prayers and financial support to keep us on the air in your area and on your favorite radio station. If you'd like to help us, write to us at Gospel Time, Box 68, Bone Gap, Illinois, 62815. Write us today.
Now on Gospel Time, it's hymn time.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole wide world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the little bitty baby in his hands. He's got the little bitty baby in his hands. He's got the little bitty baby in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole wide world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got a you and me, brother, in his hands. He's got a you and me, sister, in his hands. He's got a you and me, brother, in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
You might be a self-centered egomaniac if
your favorite song is me, 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 me,
your
me,
three
me.
Favorite people are me, myself, and I.
You send yourself Valentine's Day cards.
You are self-centered if
all you think about is yourself.
You may say you trust God, but you still have to be in control of your life.
Me, 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 me.
Can't make a commitment to God because of what it might cost you.
It'll cost you a lot more if you don't follow Christ.
Mm-hmm. 1 Timothy chapter 4 says, give yourself entirely to the cause of Christ.
And that takes a lot of effort and discipline, but it's worth it.
Because nothing's more rewarding than following Christ.
And so what's holding you back?
It all boils down to selfishness.
Read 1 Timothy 4, and it will help the selfish streak in your life.
Give everything to God, and you'll find more than you thought.
That's some insight from the pages of Our Daily Bread.
Now we listen to Allison Durham Spear, and this is called I'm Bound for That City. You're listening to Gospel Time.
There's a city of light where there cometh no night. For the sun never sets in the sky. In the Bible we're told that the streets are pure gold and a cool city.
There's nothing so unappealing as ingratitude, and nothing more appealing than a grateful woman. This is Elizabeth George for A Woman After God's Own Heart. Think how God touches your life with mercy, how He provides you with things that maybe you take for granted, like food or a place to live. When have you experienced God's comfort in sorrow, at moments of trouble? As a woman who loves God, you're privileged to enjoy what He provides for you, His solutions to your every problem. You probably know Psalm 23. It begins, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." Said in a little more modern tone, "Because the Lord guides me, I will never be in need." That works for me. This is Elizabeth George.
Now here's some gospel bluegrass music for you from the Rochesters. It's called "Send the Rain."
I'm tired of just the same old thing. Tradition, we're in your name. I'm tired of the man-made worship fire.
That's all the time they're going to give us for today's Gospel Time program. A reminder that Gospel Time stays on the air in your area and on your favorite radio station because of your prayers and your financial support. If you'd like to help us, here is our mailing address. It's Gospel Time, Post Office Box 68, Bone Gap, Illinois, and our zip code is 62815. Thanks for listening to our program today. Until our next radio broadcast, if the Lord's willing, this is Dave Rigg asking the Lord to richly bless you.